Hi everyone, this is the Billiards Doctor. Today I want to teach you about topspin, okay, or front spin. So when we do topspin, we are trying to get the cue ball to travel forward as much as possible. So here's an example of a topspin shot. I'm going to line it up. I'm going to be hitting towards the top of the ball. And we're going to follow through and see how the cue ball travels like that. Now notice that it jumped that time. If you hit it really hard, sometimes you're gonna get the cue ball to jump like that. That's actually not a good thing. Because what happens is that when the cue ball jumps and it hits the table again, it's gonna lose a lot of the spin that it had. So that's something to keep in mind. You don't want to be jumping. But key tips when you do topspin shots is that in order to get the maximum amount of topspin, you wanna hit as high on the cue ball as possible. However, there is a point where the higher you hit on the cue ball, you actually don't generate more topspin. Dr. Dave, who is an engineer out of Colorado, has done experiments and has discovered, and I agree with him on this, that the maximum point of return on your topspin shot is going to be 3/4 the way up on the cue ball. So if you were to look at the cue ball and say the bottom of the cue ball, right, to the very top, you were to divide that such that the middle of the cue ball is in half, 3/4 the way up to the top of the cue ball is going to be the point where you're going to get the maximum topspin. Okay? That makes sense. Okay, so other things to keep in mind during the topspin shot. Make sure you chop up. If you're gonna wanna chop, you may make this cue, and that's not gonna be good. Other things, when you shoot the ball, you wanna make sure that you hit the cue as flat as possible. So you want the cue to be parallel to the table during the shot. That's really important. Another thing is you wanna make sure that the cue stays parallel to the table. What I mean by that is sometimes when people do a topspin shot, they tend to hit the cue ball and they tend to lift their cue up like this. And that's not gonna be good, because you're gonna be minimizing the amount of time that the cue ball is making contact with the cue. And you wanna maximize that amount of time to maximize the topspin. Obviously, the harder you hit the cue ball, the more topspin that you're gonna get. But you wanna hit, like I said, 3/4 of the way to the top, and the bottom of the top, you wanna hit 3/4 of the way up, and you wanna have a strong follow through, and you wanna keep the cue as level as possible. When I go to this cue, like this, want to hit 3/4 of the way up, level cue, and just like that, we get tons of cue ball travel. So those are some things to keep in mind, and topspin shots are very, very helpful, especially in games like 9-ball, where you need to travel the cue ball a lot. Okay, now I want to talk quickly about doing top right and top left spin. So when you do top right spin, it's going to be like we talked about earlier with side spin. You're going to have to compensate for the squirt. So let me put the ball here. You want to use top right spin, we're going to hit this rail, it's going to shoot around. So I'm going to hit top of the right, and you want to make sure you chalk every time. The top right of the top, sorry, we're doing top left spin here. So top left of the cue ball, you want to compensate by aiming further to the left. You want to follow through. And I actually messed up there. You can see that the cue ball is spinning a lot, but didn't go very far. And that's actually a great example of doing just left spin. You can see how the left spin didn't really take because the cue ball didn't accelerate into the rail. So this time, I'm going to do it right, where I'm going to hit with top left, and what's going to happen is the top spin is going to take it to the rail. The left spin is what's going to cause it to travel. So I'm going to hit top left. There we go. See that? See how it's sped up? You got a little unlucky there because I'm going to hit the tip. I'll do one more time just to show you guys. But when we do this top left spin, it's going to speed up off the rail. There we go. See all that cue ball travel? And it's spinning a ton right now. So obviously, most times you don't have to do that much topspin, but it may come in handy. So another really great shot to do that they do in 9-ball, I have to do it on this side because I'm left-handed, is that if you need to get around the table, they like to do what's called inside English, which means that I'm gonna hit top left on this 8-ball, it's gonna make the 8-ball, it's gonna hit this rail here, it's gonna spin around the table. See that? See the cue ball spun all the way around the table. It was a relatively straight shot with a little bit of an angle, but with that top left, it was able to hit the rail and spin off and accelerate around. Okay? So that is topspin. Topspin is a great shot to practice, it's a great shot that you should be doing. To set up for balls too, quite a bit. If you get ball in hand, you have a choice to decide between hitting a ball with topspin or backspin. Always use topspin. So if I want to make the 12 and then make the 9 after, I have two options. I can hit this, say it's in the middle like this, and you get on the nine ball. I can hit this with backspin and try to get just the right amount. That was pretty good. Pretty much perfect there. Or it's actually easier if I do topspin. So it's easier to get position when you use topspin. So I'm gonna use topspin. Also perfect. Just like that, nine ball, game over. Okay? So when you're trying to set up for balls, really try to do topspin over backspin. That being said, oftentimes there's shots you have to use backspin, but if you have a ball in hand scenario and you're trying to set up for a second shot, topspin is a much easier shot to control. So that's topspin. This is the Billiards Doctor. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more videos.